You know, that's why we're encouraged to, you know, look a little bit deeper. We're deeper people.
Boom. Man, fascinating stuff. And I know for some people, the over-commercialization of this kind of material, the New Age community in general, yeah, it can turn some people off. It can make them skeptical. But, man, your eloquence, it really drives me to put stock in what you're throwing down because it's just so dense. And, you know, I'm just a humble stoner trying to hang on. But I do love it. And I guess just before we get out of here, we talked so much about balance. And you did mention pH balance and diet and even breath. But to leave the people with something tangible, what other balancing activities would you recommend for people who might be kind of energized at this moment and kind of looking for the next step?
Well, the main thing is actually to come out of judgment. See, everything that I mentioned today, I was generally mindful at telling people, you know, well, like even with the bad guys, they're just characters in the play. You know, at the end of the day, you know, they're playing their role. They're holding up that particular part of the spectrum. It doesn't mean that we want to go be that or join that. But, you know, we learned from that. That's kind of like a contrast to what you don't want to be in a certain tense. So what I feel like is that one of the biggest things that allowed me to transcend a lot of the brain drain, mental drain, spiritual drain, physical drain, which keeps us from going into the higher states of consciousness, is just the judgments and writing something off. Because if we never see the other side to things, then we actually won't see the other side to ourselves. Because let us all not make a mistake in believing that there's still an essence of even what the Illuminati is doing within everyone. Even when a person flies down the street in their car and burns up all that oil and blows out the part of the environment. So we're all playing our part in this. So this means that in many tenses that if we get to the point where we're not judging, we're just actually making sense of all of it and putting it into its proper place, because that's what a supreme being does. When everything is in its place, then it works perfectly. And I put this into a metaphor by letting people understand that manure, shit, is horrible to eat, but it works great for plants. So it's just about where you're putting it to determine what its true use is and what its true purpose is. And I find everything to be that way, that when things are out of place, then you got unbalance. So that's the first thing, because then if you judge it, you never realize that subconsciously that you're actually judging yourself. All is self. So what it requires is it requires maturity. This is why the adept is adult. These are almost the same word. Because adult and the adept is capable of using compassion to deal with the children. This means like mediocre concepts and things that still need to be graduated into a higher state. This is the adept is using compassion, because that's also the trait of the divine feminine, which we all have. We're positive and negative beings. We're male and female, even if we feel polarized towards one or another. And that compassion is that even if a woman, a real woman, has a retarded child, she will take care of that child. If the child is disfigured, she will still take care of that child and love that child like it's the same as all other children, because that's compassion. Versus when a person lacks compassion, if there's a flaw, then they're discarding it. They're not even going to try to work, repair it, help it, any of that. So this is a part of when we gain back that other side, because remember what we talked about today. Most of the reality is designed in the masculine structure, in the fiery burning, etc. So this means that we're generally lacking the feminine side of ourselves. And that's why the feminine side of the consciousness is the spiritual side, right? And we're just, again, we're not talking about female woman. We're talking about what's behind the eyes. So what happens is that this balance is serious. We have to really, really look at, in our lives, are we getting too much of one and not enough of the other? And then how to put that into balance is stop focusing on all this external stuff that you can judge, you know, because that's also a reflection to when we can't change anything. We just choose to judge. Oh, man, she's just got the wrong clothes on today. Look at that. Just raggedy, you know, and just, oh, my goodness, I can't believe he's with that dog. That dog is a maniac. And if we start watching our minds, we'll find that the mind spends all of its time judging, because it's trapped in Cain and Abel. It's trapped in the two temples. So that's one of the big pointers, is find the meaning, solve that coagula, meaning actually find the solution here. Don't just keep highlighting the problem, and never believe for one moment that the solution doesn't exist, because the solution exists before the problem. The root to the word solution is soul. Surely the sun existed before the shadows. The shadows are the problems. It's like the Plato's cave as an analogy. The shadows don't bear witness at all to what's casting them. So we're encouraged, instead of trying to blame the first immediate thing you see, to look beyond, but even that beyond being within, and say, okay, where is this going on in me? Because I'm only seeing a mirror and a reflection. So that's the greatest pointer that I can really give today, is for us to work with our compassion. And as I said, etymologically, it's the compass to Zion. Zion is a projection of the mental, spiritual, and physical mainframe. That's why Sony is so deep into the virtual reality and so deep into technology, because they create Zion. And so for us, because Zion just means a projection, to get through it, because that's what people need. They need that bearing. You have to find yourself more willing to actually assist and switch the polarity, because the polarity for most people is take, 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 take. They seldom give anything. And that means, though, that they haven't tapped into the most powerful force, which is known by the to the Kemetans as the subjective plane. Subjective plane is only giving. The reason it does this is because it knows a deep secret. When it gives something, the only thing everyone else is going to do is go create something out of that. And so because of that action, it will live through it. So I'll make it simple. The subjective plane is pure energy, unhindered, undetermined, undefined. It has abundance of it. It will never run out. It's limitless. When a person takes from the subjective plane, they can only create something with it. When they create something with it, it actually becomes that. And I can leave everyone with this this experience that I had. I was on top of a mountain, and I actually had blown open the third eye. And at this point, I could either go into sheer terror or laugh at what I was seeing, because now I was once again way over my head. And I was beholding the entire landscape and how it was all actually one form, which was too much to take, because it was a large life form. And you got from the frequency and the energy that the whole world was one life form. I mean, you're really getting it. You're just not hearing. I mean, they tell you that, you know, the world's alive and blah, blah, blah. But those are words. Words are not experiences. So when you're actually in there and you see the whole thing. But what was most flooring to me, what took me aback, I was taken aback, was because it was even the things that we call inorganic. Meaning that the cars, the trees, and all the other things were all part of this being. And when I laughed, because that's the only other thing, you sometimes get stuck like Joker in that position, but when I laughed at the whole thing just to keep from folding under what I was beholding, then it explained. See, that's what I did. I disguised myself as every single thing that my children are using, because they still don't want to come to me. Mm-hmm. And it's because if you really think about it, every single thing that we build, we pull from the earth. Whether it's, I don't care if it's plastic, I don't care if it's glass. The only thing that we do is we pull it from the earth and we, like clay, mold it into something else. And we say, oh, TV. But we're never realizing that all of this stuff is actually coming from one massive life form. And that one massive life form is living through all this stuff and watching us and interacting with us through that. And until we're ready to see it as it really is, all one thing, then we're not ready to graduate. But once we do, that's when we become everything. Say, all seeing, all knowing. There's no place to place to take anything from, because where would you put it? Mm-hmm. You see, and that's what we're talking. There's nothing to talk to because no one's listening. It's like that's the totality of our power, and we can prove this from a fact that it exists. It's more firm for us to stand on than concepts that are far-fetching and external, etc. So I encourage people to, I mean, if you know you have the time. Check out the InterVersity. It's on secretenergy.com. We go through this methodically, you know, because this today, you know, we did we had a smorgasbord. Yes. Like, you know, it's a little bit in there for everyone. But, you know, if a person's looking for, okay, I need that particular topic to be, we need to drill into that. I need to know everything about, you know, what's going on with my body, or, you know, what is my real connection with the cosmos? And, you know, those kind of things is what's really addressed, because everybody kept saying, you know, hey, you know, if you one day could put all this, you know, one particular topic. And so the university consists of seven or nine different topics that we cover. And so that's what's up. And also, you know, just to let everyone know, I have much compassion for our species. So this is why, you know, this has been nonstop. Like, somebody could listen to the first recording and see that I was still going on like this. It may be about something different. Like, the words are backwards, and that's why it turns your brain into a certain direction, hence the term backwards. But, I mean, there's so many jewels and gems, and it was because it was given to me, pressed down and running over, meaning that there's no end to this. Once we tap into it, it's us. Mm-hmm. So that's why I don't actually, you know, it's not hard for me to get in here and do this, because this is about us. And because I'm an optimist, I'm only looking forward to the times that I've already seen, which is when we're all together. So that's what's up.